Greetings, I am Anne, and this is Home and Work. Many times our jobs and studies expose us to heat, even in our daily lives every day we are exposed to this risk, but how is form the fire? What is it required to that be present? Why sometimes it keeps alive until consumed everything in its path, and another time simply it turns off after a while or even instantly. Can there be fire without the presence of flames? To understand better this is essential that we know the fire triangle, for there to fire will need at least three elements, which are combustible, comburant and activation energy. One, the combustible, that is the material to be burned during combustion, which can be found in solid state, such as wooden coal, liquid state, such as gasoline and kerosene, and gaseous state, such as liquefied gas and biogas. The heat will change this solid or liquid combustible to liquid and or gaseous state. To the comburant or oxidant, that is a substance that oxidizes the combustible. The most common example is the oxygen, which forms about 21% of the air around us. Although may vary depending on the height or if the space where we are is closed, another comburants are the ozone and hydrogen peroxide. 3. The activation energy. It will usually be a heat source as another previously lit fire, embers, sparks, electric shocks, concentrated sources of light, radiation, and even some waves. Therefore, we must pay attention to the signs that besides so to prohibit us to ignite fire or smoking in certain areas, they don't allow us to use cell phones or other devices. By understanding the fire triangle we can understand more the nature of the fire and more importantly its origin. Now, knowing this we can eliminate one or more of its elements to prevent or stop the fire. 1. Removal or neutralization of fuel, also called insulation. By eliminating the fuel the fire will be extinguished or will not start, so it is important the existence of firewalls we can find in nature like rivers or rocks. We can create them artificially putting stones and sand, also move away the combustible materials such as paper or dry leaves around bonfires and grills. Firefighters, foresters, rangers and other conservationists recommend create trails between the groves to prevent that the fire will consume nearby areas. If you will work with tools that produce heat or sparks, as grinders, weldings and blowtorch, is important that we remove all combustible material. If we cannot move said flammable material, such as a wooden house or green areas, well, we can always cover it with a fireproof material such as incombustible cloth or fireproof paints. Also we can irrigate on green areas, since water is not combustible. Besides extinguishing media mentioned before, such water, sand and in some cases certain minerals that contain fuel spills, plus of course dry chemical and certain gases that not only put out the fire also create a kind of fireproof defense on the materials. Obviously each method works best when combined with others. The most successful anti-fire operation is not the extinction, but rather prevention. 2. Removal or neutralization of comburant or oxidant, also called suffocation. As when we turn off a candle by a strong puff with which we move the air around the wick, in jobs where they cannot eliminate fuels and sources of energy we will opt to remove oxygen. Working in insulated areas of comburant, independent of the amount of heat and fuel the fire is not started, it sounds complicated, right? But in our homes, jobs, study centers are means of transport. We can carry carbon dioxide extinguishers that displace oxygen. The fireproof blankets mentioned above can also be very useful to cover potential small fires. Moreover, to spray water on the fire, provided this is not in contact with electrical currents, will produce water steam, which is very effective to displace oxygen in enclosed areas. Since the water passing from liquid to gaseous increase its volume by more than 1,500 times. 3. Removal or neutralization of heat, also called cooling. In this case water is critical, as usually it has a low temperature, and even if it's not cold water absorbs a lot of heat before evaporating. To this useful element we add liquid and gaseous extinguishers that also absorb energy and heat of the fire, as well as cool the fuel and or the air. With these data, We already have a basic understanding of how fire works, but left many questions unanswered. We will see in the near future. If you liked the video, you can gift me a like, share, and subscribe to my channel or follow me on the social networks to be aware of the following episodes. You can comment if you have questions or want to see other videos. I have more channels with less serious topics as video games or cartoons. Until next time.